Welcome to part one. Today what we're going to be looking at is the navigation around procedures, how to create them, and other factors that will play into actually developing a procedure itself. So there's a few ways of making procedures. I'll be covering that first. So the first way you can create a procedure is by clicking on the green plus icon when you're under the mod elements tab. And then there is one under P. You can also press the key bind P to create a new procedure. Then you can give it a name. We'll just call this one test for this instance. And then you will be presented with this kind of screen. The other way of creating a procedure is through another element. So if we go to, for example, blocks, we'll just create a dummy block here, and then we can go to the triggers, and usually things that are related to that particular one have triggers which you can create a procedure for. And if you click on the plus icon next to the thing, it will give you a default name for what's related to your block, and then you can create a procedure, and that will create a procedure that way as well. So those are the general ways of creating procedures. Going through procedures, there are a few different things that you might want to know about before we continue in the series. And the first thing is your procedure blocks are located on the left-hand side. So all these different tabs here are going to have different procedure blocks and stuff. As you can see, if we click on the procedure block tab that we want and then click on a sub-tab, sometimes they don't have sub-tabs. But then you can see that there's a whole bunch of different blocks under this particular block actions one. And then there's, for example, conditional ones, which are usually under data. And there's other tabs that might be related to those things as well. Like this is for block energy and fluid. So those are the general tabs over here. When you install plugins and stuff, you might also have tabs for those. For example, I have file manager installed, so you can see that I have all these tabs here for file manager. And then there, I also have the block state one, which is also a plugin. So those are, we'll be just covering the vanilla ones for the blocks and stuff this season, but, tutorial series. Now, the other thing that is important is local variables. When you have a procedure itself, basically you can use local variables, which are specifically for the instance of that time the procedure is run. So they're not saved to the game itself or any particular element. Once the procedure is finished, it is wiped and there is no more variables. So it doesn't store the data, only temporarily while the procedure is running. To create local variables, you can click on the local variables tab. It'll be right up at the top here. And it's a green icon. You can click on it, give it a name, and then you can select what kind of variable type you want. If you have mods or plugins and stuff, you might also see a few different plugin or tabs here as well. File manager has a few of them, like file, JSON array, and JSON object, but all the other ones are vanilla wise. So once you created one of those, you can actually manipulate the blocks and stuff. We'll be getting into that a little bit later in a future video because it's pretty advanced stuff. But we will be looking at it after we get through all the basic learning of the stuff like that. But right now, just know that that's where the procedure editor or local variables are. And then we have dependencies. So down at the bottom on the right hand side, we have the global trigger. This is basically saying what the dependencies are. So these are dependencies for this particular trigger. And the one above where it says required dependencies, that's the ones that we're actually using. So we can't go outside of the list of the one that we're actually using. We'll be covering all the dependencies in a separate video this in the next couple months for sure. So definitely tune in for that because we'll be deep diving on all that you need to know about the dependencies. The last thing last couple things that I should talk about is warnings. So for example, any warnings that you come up with are going to be displayed down at the bottom here. For example, if we remove this, we have a condition that doesn't have anything. It will actually say down at the bottom that warnings and errors, and then we'll basically list any warnings and errors down at the bottom here. In this case, we don't, it doesn't find a if block without a main body, so to fix that issue, you just put it back on. But the other thing is the code viewer. Sometimes this will help with figuring out where things are in your codes when debugging and stuff. You can click on the button right next to the help icon, help button right at the top here, and it will list all the things that are going on in the procedure. The nice thing about this is when you remove something, it will actually highlight the area that has been affected, and then you can actually place it on and see what it has generated. So it can help with debugging and stuff like that as well. So that's basically it for this video. It's a really short video. I know it's like 6 minutes, but that's the basic navigation of the procedure editor. Next episode, what we'll be covering is procedure templates. We'll be learning how to where templates are found, as well as saving your own templates and stuff like that. So definitely tune in for that as well. And I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.